Hello everyone, and welcome to Sine of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and today we are going to cover several aspects of polynomials, including how to write a polynomial in ascending order, descending order, how to get the coefficient of each term, the degree of each term, and finally, how to get the leading term as well as the leading coefficient. So, let's get started. First, let's consider a polynomial that only contains one variable, say x. We could be asked to write the polynomial in ascending order or ascending powers of x. Ascending just means from smallest to biggest. In this polynomial, 8 has a degree of 0, 2x has a degree of 1, minus x squared has a degree of 2, minus 11x cubed has a degree of 3, and finally, 5x to the power of 7, of course, has a degree of 7, and so it is written last. It is more common, however, to be asked to write a polynomial in descending order or descending powers of x. Descending just means from biggest to smallest. So when we take this polynomial and we write it in descending order, we notice that the order of the terms is the exact opposite to when they are written in ascending order. The coefficient of each term is just the number that appears before the variable in each term. And please, please, please don't forget to write the negative signs where there are any, as they do form part of the coefficients. In this example, minus x squared can be written as minus 1x squared, which means that its coefficient is negative 1, while 8 can be written as 8x to the power of 0, which means that 8 is actually the coefficient of x to the power of 0. The degree of each term is simply the exponent of the variable of each term. In this polynomial, 2x can be written as 2x to the power of 1, while, as we've said, 8 can be written as 8x to the power of 0. The leading term is the term that has the highest degree. And if we've written the polynomial in descending order, then it will be the first term, which in this example is 5x to the power of 7. And finally, the leading coefficient is simply the coefficient of the leading term, which in this example is 5. Next, let's consider a polynomial that contains two different variables. If this is the case, to get the degree of each term, we simply add up the exponents of the variables of each term. If we are asked to write the polynomial in ascending order, we simply write the terms in order from the smallest degree to the highest degree. And if asked to write the polynomial in descending order, we do the exact opposite. We write the terms from the highest degree down to the lowest degree. Again, the coefficient of each term is just the number that appears before the variables. And please don't forget any negative signs. The degree of each term is just the sum of the exponents of the variables of each term. The leading term is the one that contains the highest degree. And finally, the leading coefficient is the coefficient of that leading term. And don't forget the negative sign. I hope that you now have a better understanding of how to write polynomials in ascending and descending order, how to get the coefficients and the degrees of each term, and finally, how to get the leading term as well as the leading coefficient. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.